Hi folks, today I bring you a dinosaur from the world of the clocks in the single chip. It exists in the form of two pinout models. In this case, we will focus on the MM5387AAN from the National Semiconductors. One of the biggest problems with these components is that a quick look at the names of their pins can lead to the serious errors made when I connected the circuit power supply. I recommend watching a video made about another IC where one attempt is made to explain the reason for the conflict between the VSS and the VDD, which I will leave the link to in the description. Anyway, I adding from the outset that the difficulty in the nomenclature arises around the technology of the P-channels, MOS, enhancement and the depletion. So let's go. This clock allows the configuration of the 12 or 24 in the time format as it supports 3.5 digits reconfiguration the segment's connections to the first digit on the left in order to support the digit 1 or 2, making use of the AM, PM and Hertz segments to support the digit 2. We can define to the base of the clock at 50 Hz or 60 Hz, and there is also a specific pin for this purpose. Note that this reference is taken direct from your power supply, that is from the sector via the power transformer. A warning for the most unwary switches, power support supplies cannot be used in this mode of use unless one external 60 Hz generator is used. What requires more care is certainly the power supply to our IC. In general, the VDD, whether it is in the CMOS family or the TTL, is always positive, be it plus. VSS is always as a GND or less. Here in our clock, VSS is positive and the VDD is negative. These require a lot of attention. The IC datasheet states that the power supply can vary between 24 and 26 volts. The maximum value of the 30 volts is mentioned in datasheet. It is mentioned that the power failure is reported below 7.5 volts. I tested the operation with 9 volts and everything worked perfect. It is important to mention that in this clock we are analyzing, we used a VFD. However, most of the clocks integrated in the famous clocks radius used LED displays of some size. I pass some wires from the clock to the breadboard to implement the control of the buttons. I implement the fast slow the alarm adjust. I can press with fast button and adjust the time. Okay. Of course, you can implement only the buttons you make attention of the use. Is an alarm, the clear of the alarm, the sleep mode, clear. This is the basic functions of the buttons, okay? Fast forward, slow forward, clear alarm, set sleep. In this case, of course, I can adjust the time to the sleep and the clear of the sleep. At this moment, the power up of the system is done with 7.5 volts. Okay. This is the power present in the system, is 9.63, okay? Because you know DC voltage is the value of the AC voltage by square root of the 2, okay? I changed the secondary of the transformer and now I power up the system with 18 volts. The display is blinking because is one way you have the sure the time is secure. The clock don't show the wrong time. If the system fail, or the power up fail, after when it turn on again, the system blinking display has one way to inform something is wrong, okay? If I press a button to adjust the time, the system stay fixed, okay? Now, because I changed the secondary of the transformer, the power up of our system is near of the 24 volts, okay? This value result the value of AC voltage by square root of 2. The filament is powered by a secondary of the transformer with 7.5 volts AC, and I insert a resistor of 50 ohms in serial with one of the filaments, one of the wires of the coming from the filaments. And please don't forget add the reference between the filaments and our negative voltage, okay? This is very important because if the reference is not present, the system not display nothing, okay? If this wire here, and you see that only with the reference the display working. I use a transformer with a secondary impedant of the 18 volts, another with 7.5 volts. And the first time I used the one with 2 times 7.5 because have a middle point of the coil. But one secondary of the 18 volts and the 7.5 volts enough, okay? You can see here the connections. This is to power up our IC, and this is to power up our filaments.